Welcome, neighbors. Welcome, young and old. You've come just in time for our story to begin. Long ago, in a small village, there lived a humble shoemaker named Martin. Martin was known throughout the village as a good man, a man who loved his neighbor, a man who would come awake. The sun is rising on the village, and today is Christmas Eve.
Poor Sarah, she's so very practical. She almost makes me doubt myself sometimes. I wish I had something to give the Savior when he comes. What do I have to offer? What can I give him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would bring him a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would do my part. But what can I give him? I'll give him my heart. Give him my heart. Give him my heart. What can I give him but all of my heart? Give him my heart. Give him my heart. What can I give him but all of my heart?
Wood for sale! Wood for sale! Wood for sale!
Oh, I think he's finally here, and it's only Thomas with his miserable wood. Happy Christmas to you, Thomas!
Oh, ho, ho, the cobbler! The last of the optimists! But it's colder out here than a Russian blizzard! And I'm stuck with these miserable sticks I couldn't sell. My rheumatism is acting up. My wife has been bedridden for 2 years. But my old friend the cobbler commands me to have a happy Christmas.
Come in, Thomas. I'll get you some soup. It will improve your outlook.
Oh, ho, ho. If that's the case, you must have a magic soup pot in there.
Welcome, welcome. Don't bother to wipe your feet. My good woman never complains.
Oh, is that right?
Sit down, I'll get the soup.
Martin, you look very festive here. Are you expecting someone?
It's hard to say. I'm expecting and I'm not expecting.
Oh, as always, Mark, you are perfectly clear.
Well, you see, yesterday I was reading of Christ's life here on earth and how he walked among us, and men received him not. The innkeeper locked his door, and the Pharisee locked his heart. And then I fell asleep, I think I did. And then I heard a voice, at least I think I heard a voice, and it said to me, Martin, Martin, look for me tomorrow. I am coming. And that was all. But all day long, I've been expecting him, and he should be here any time.
The Lord coming here? If that's the case, I'd best be on my way.
You laugh, you're just like Sarah. You think God is in heaven with his back turned.
No, Martin, I'd never laugh at you. You are just foolish enough to be wise. But I must go. Thanks for the soup. I believe my engine is warm enough to run again.
Oh, wait just a minute. I got to talking about my hoped-for guest. But I forgot about your boots. They're finished, good as new.
Oh, Martin, they're beautiful. You are many things, my friend, but you are also a cobbler, and a good one at that. What do I owe you?
Who speaks of money on Christmas Eve? Take them, they're a gift. But when you're walking through the snow, think of your old friend, the crazy cobbler.
You are a good man, my friend, a vanishing breed. I'm sorry for your sake that I can't believe in your visitor. But I will say this, if I were the Lord and I decided to visit this miserable planet, I'd go first to Martin the cobbler. Good night.
I'd go first to Martin the cobbler. Oh, why not? He's the only person who gives his work away for free.
Oh, Sarah, you're just angry about the boots. I can't take money from Thomas. His life is too hard.
And ours is easy. You call this luxury? Oh, no one can ever know what a trial it is to be married to a truly good man.
You know what, Sarah? You're just worried that the whole world is going to discover your little secret, that your bark is bigger than your bite.
Don't be so sure about that, old man.
Joy to the world, the Lord is
come. Listen, the carols are singing.
Christ was born to save,
Christ was born to save,
for Christ. Jesus, the Savior,
Martin, do you call those shoes? Come in. Come in. Here, sit down. What brings you to our town on Christmas Eve? I've never seen you before.
I'm looking for my husband. He went to sea and should have been back a month ago. We've only been married just a little while, and well, we were going to start a farm. But with the harsh weather, we couldn't make it work, so he went back to the only work he knew, and now he's gone.
I am so sorry, my dear.
My sweet husband's gone, and I can't find him. I'm sure his ship has just been delayed, and he'll get word to me as soon as he can.
You poor child. I cannot help you find your husband, but this I can do. Here, please, put these on.
Oh, thank you.
And this is a gift from my wife.
Oh, you mustn't give me your wife's shawl. She might not like it.
That's where you're wrong. She would love you to have that. But don't go now. Stay a little bit longer until you feel better.
No, I must go find my husband. I'll ask the sailors at the docks if they've heard any news.
Then go with God, little one. May you find the peace that you seek.
I thought I heard a visitor. Any news?
It was just the poor child who needed a place to warm herself.
Please, Martin, come lie down a while. The age of miracles is over.
No, I'll wait a little longer.
Yes, they are all dressed up for the season.
Susie, look what I got my sister for Christmas. Oh, it's absolutely darling.
Apple. Look at that, Apple. Look at that. Whoa, back here, thief. You rascal thief. Get you. Get back.
Stop. Stop, little mother. Him.
Forgive him? Forgiving with my cane, I plan on beating him all the way to jail.
Let him go, little mother. Remember the Bethlehem child, and it's Christmas Eve. He'll promise me better. Here, boy, tell old Anna you're sorry.
I'm sorry.
That's right. And here's an apple for you.
Yeah.
No. I'll pay you for it.
No. Okay. I guess you're right. This is no time for ill will. After all, Christmas is about a child, isn't it? Thank you, young man. Thank you for reminding me. Apple?
If you won't take a nap like a sensible man, rest in your chair. It won't be long before church.
I know. The hours slip by, and still he hasn't come. I suppose you were right.
Yes, I was right. Rest a little while.
Thank you.
as Martin slept, he had another wondrous dream. In it, he saw his neighbor Thomas.
Martin, do you know me?
Of course I know you. You're Thomas, my old friend.
Martin, do you not know me? I am the least of these.
Martin, do you know me?
Yes, you were just here a minute ago. We talked for a while.
But Cobbler, don't you know me? Can you fail to know who I am? I am the least of these.
Martin, do you know me?
But yes, of course, and you're still wearing Sarah's shawl.
But Martin, do you not know me? Do you still refuse to know who I am? I am the least of these.
For I was thirsty, and you gave me drink.
And I was a stranger, and you took me in.
And I had wandered, was angry and lost, and you showed me the way.
But Lord, I only saw my fellow man, and helped him on his way.
Inasmuch as ye have done it.
Done it unto the least of these, my brethren.
Ye have done it unto me.
Martin, wake up. It's time for church. Why do you look so happy?
Sarah, the whole time I was preparing for Christ's return, I forgot one very important thing.
And what is that?
Jesus said, "Lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world."
Thank you.
and join us in singing, O Come All Ye Faithful.